We should be working to live, not living to work. We live in a time where most of us are just go, 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 where the hustle just never sleeps. I get it. If you have high ambitions, then your work ethic should match it. But your body and especially your mind are only built to handle so much. Life is about balance and boundaries. Too much of one thing is never a good thing. What good is all of this effort to create a nice life if you can't slow down and actually enjoy it? With Property by Ashley, and I'm here today to talk about something that's super important to me, quality of life. So we're gonna go over the value and importance, what quality of life means for different people, and how you can implement it in your day-to-day activities. Okay, so quality of life can mean different things to different people. I know that for me, when I think of quality of life, the word balance comes to mind. You know, that teeter-totter of between work and play, like what's appropriate, what's not. I don't care what other people are doing and what other people's definitions of like hustling and grind is. I hustle and I grind in my life. I mean, obviously there's a dictionary with the definition of what hustle and grind is, but that doesn't mean that you have to get up at 4 a.m. and work until 10 p.m. and then you don't see any of your friends and family and you're completely burnt out, you know, if you do. I like to switch up my days. So I try to take a weekend on Sunday, Monday. That doesn't always happen. Sundays happen, but Mondays don't always happen. And throughout the week though, I am working, I'm eating right, I'm exercising, but then throughout my day, I take breaks. So I will go to the dog park in the middle of the day. I will work out in the middle of the day. I will sometimes work out in the morning, or sometimes it's not preferred, but I'll work out in the evening if I have to. So I'm pretty regimented during the week, but then on the weekends, it's really nice to just not have a schedule.
I'm having so much fun with the kids. We are at Pine something. I don't remember the name. But we're about to go to Delfino Farms, so I'll show you guys more there. They have yummy food and wine tasting, so that's definitely more my jam.
So being regimented for me means time blocking. I definitely look at my schedule every Sunday and plan out, okay, these are the days that I'm doing these things. I have to vlog this day and time block a couple of hours for that. That's something I'm still working on. So anyways, the whole point is, you know, working Monday through Friday, 9 to 5, is obviously a 40-hour work week. And I definitely work 40 hours, probably more, but it's not Monday through Friday, 9 to 5, in an office, sitting behind a screen, where I'm completely tied to that space, because for me, that's not quality of life. Everyone's different. Like I said, some people love that stuff and that's the only way they can get work done and they thrive that way, and that's totally amazing. But when I was doing that, I was miserable. Like, I didn't have the energy to do anything else at the end of the day. I just wasn't happy. And I am so happy now with my more flexible schedule that I've created for myself. So that being said, we have full control over our days and our attitudes and how our life pans out, right? It's our life, we have control of it. Whatever we don't like, we have the power to change. You know, there's things that we can do that we're in control of. I hear a lot of people complaining on a daily basis of they don't like what situation they're in, whether it be their relationship or their work environment, and we have control to change that. So I hope that with a little bit of encouragement and support, then everybody is where they wanna be. And obviously there's different sacrifices different people have to make for their situation, but you know, we have control of our attitude about it too. I want you to find that balance. I want you to find that quality of life. I hope that you do. And if you need any words of encouragement, advice from someone who's taken the leap before and taken a chance, then I am happy to share my experience with you. And I want to help you find how you can make it work for you so that you're just as happy as I am.